Hi everyone, I am Eva Urbano and I will present the poster exposing our research, which has been performed as a collaboration between Universitat Politécnica de Catalunya in Spain and Universidad Autónoma de Querétaro in Mexico. The objective of our work is to provide industrial small and medium enterprises with a suitable framework to analyze their energy investments, which might be required due to obsolescence of existing equipment or due to social and political pressures arising from the green energy transition. Despite the important role that industrial SMEs play in the energy market and the possibility to adopt a prosumer model, their energy use is generally under research, and most of the studies available up to date focus solely on energy efficiency measures. There are only few papers that address the energy investment problems for industrial SMEs, transforming them into a more active actor in the energy market, but they fail to represent the reality of the investment reality of these entities due to two main reasons. That is, they do not consider the time evolution of parameters and they do not analyze the risk of the investment. In our research, this gap is fulfilled by proposing this methodological framework. First of all, what we do is to optimize the energy equipment for the industrial SME. This optimization is carried out in a two-stage approach. The equipment is selected in the first stage, whereas the operation of the equipment is optimized in the second stage for its complete lifetime and considering a prosumer model. In this way, it is possible to compute the net present value of the investment and select the one with better economic perspectives. Once the equipment is obtained, to evaluate the risk related to it, the uncertainty in the cost of energy carriers, which are electricity and gas, is characterized and expressed as probability density functions. This characterization is performed considering the different market prognoses, evaluating the potential evolution that this cost will have in upcoming years. Then, it is possible to do an uncertainty analysis. In this analysis, the probability density functions of the inputs are sampled through the Latin hyperquare sampling technique, and the operation optimization is repeated for each of the samples, obtaining the probability density function of the net present value of the investment. This function enables to compute the variability of the expected variability of the outcome and the risk that the enterprise is facing when performing the energy investment. The methodology is applied in here to a case study based on a real manufacturing plant. With the characteristics and constraints of the analyzed plant, the equipment selected to install is a photovoltaic system that covers all the available area possible for its installation and a cogeneration. The required investment is recovered in 5 years and the net present value is almost more than 7 times the initial investment required. In these graphics, it is possible to see the operation, optimal operation of this for this equipment. As a photovoltaic system covers all the available area, an important part of the demand is covered by it, and there is also still a surplus of energy that is injected to the utility grid, obtaining a revenue. Also, a cogeneration system is employed, which serves both to cover electrical and thermal demand at the same time, minimizing the purchase of electricity from the utility grid. This operation leads to a final net present value of around 6 million euros. The uncertainty analysis has been performed and the result is the one exposed here. Through this density obtained a probability density function, it is possible to calculate the standard deviation, that is of 138,000 euros, which despite being an important value represents only the 2% of the final net present value. Therefore, despite energy carriage uncertainty is considerably high, the obtained solution through this methodology is robust in front of energy carriage variability. The presented methodology in this article solves the existing problem for industrial SMEs facing energy investment actions, and the developed case study exposes results that might enhance them to perform energy actions supporting the green energy transition. This is all from my side. I hope you have enjoyed this presentation, and if you have any questions, you can ask them now, or if you prefer, you can directly send an email to this direction. See you!